Big Bopper to March here. We're still in the game, okay? That Skag and his Flucy, they're gonna die.
Hey everyone, welcome back. It's time to start another build. This time we're going to be doing a car build. I decided that I want to do something again that is kind of on the rare side, something the model kit less seen. So I decided to do a car, and I decided that I was going to do another paper model. And this is what I'm doing, as you could see from the video earlier. And now we look back here at the parts. We're going to do the Big Bopper Falcon from Mad Max, the original Mad Max movie. Again, I chose this. I'm not a really big fan of paper car models. Because I don't think they always look very much like what they're supposed to be. And usually most car models, paper models, for cars I've seen, also come in styrene. So, of course, the styrene, I think, builds up more realistic. But in the case of this car, there is no kit for it. I mean, there's a garage kit out there, or at least there was years ago. I don't know if it's still available, like new production, that is. But if you do find the old ones, being a garage kit made out of resin, the price is extremely, extremely expensive. So in this case, a card or paper model fits the bill perfectly. And I've seen this kit built up by somebody, and it looked fantastic. It really did. So I decided I wanted to give it a try. I figured, what the heck. I found the model online for free. Some people in the modeling, the card modeling community, look down upon that kind of thing. But you know what? I'm not going to let it look a gift horse in the mouth. If it's free, I'm going to grab it. Just like if somebody gives me a styrene kit for free, I'm going to grab that too. Downloaded it. It's 5 pages for the kit, and we'll go through it. It's 5 pages. I took the download to my local Staples. I decided to have them print it out on a heavier cardstock. It's I think it's 64-65 pound paper. It's like a semi-gloss paper. I think the graphic looks really, really sharp. The kit consists of 87 parts, approximately 87 parts, 78 of which are the car itself, which is 3 pages, and then another 10 parts to build the base for it, which is a really nice feature. It has a nice base that comes with it. So let's take a look at the kit real quick. So right here, you've got the main body of the car. This is one big piece here to be cut out, okay? Fold it, put it together, these will wrap around the side. You will have a seam line coming down the side of the kit, but you know what? Again, it is what it is. And you know what? I can live with it. For the cost of this, compared to, say, the resin kit, I can deal with the seam lines. Windshield separate, the hood separate. You've got the fender flares here. I'm not sure what this is up here. I think it has to do with the sirens stuff. Same with these parts here. You've got the underside of the car here. Interior fender wells. Part of the front bumper. I'm not sure what these are here. Again, more bits and bobs. This is the light bar here with lights. They had twin blue lights on this car. These are the wheels. So this page just consists of four wheels, which there are 9 parts per wheel. I'm not sure what these pieces are right here, but these right here, these 9 parts make up one wheel. And if I can get this up enough close, enough light, you can see the detail in it. Look at the center spoke there. You can actually see the lug nuts and everything. It's pretty cool. And it's hard to see here, but on this piece right here, you can actually read the BF Goodrich on there. Then we got the base. It's got part of the highway and then some grass scene here. It's got 2 signs, the name of the road, Anarchy Road. And if you've seen the movie, you'd remember this sign about the how dangerous the highway was. And this here is just the underside to help the base be strong, the supports for the base, and tells you how to put it together. So, this kit is by far at 88 pieces, a lot more complicated than the first paper model I did, which was the Star Trek travel pod at 9 pieces. So I got my work cut out for me, but I learned a lot from that travel pod, and I think I can really, I'm hoping I can really make a go of this. So that's where we are. So we're going to get cutting some card here and doing some gluing. So until next time, or should I say, I will be right back.